Hey everyone, hope you're doing good. Up to this point in the videos, we've rigged our character and fixed some rigging issues. From here on, we're going to simulate a running animation for the character. Keep in mind, we haven't gotten into advanced rigging yet. Right now, we're just aiming to create a basic amateur run cycle. The goal is that by now you've managed to make your very first animation. If you've watched the video this far, I'd really appreciate it if you could like the video and subscribe to the channel. Alright, let's get into the rest of the video. To simulate running, you need a reference. To get a reference, just search Run Cycle Animation on Google and easily download one that fits your style. For walking, you can search Walk Cycle too. In these references, the motion is broken down step by step for you, and you should animate your character following those same steps. And again, I want to stress that we haven't reached advanced animation yet. This is just the basics and foundation of a run cycle. Alright, now we're going to place our reference image somewhere in the corner so we can see it clearly while animating the character's legs. For now, we're not going to touch the body and we're just focusing on animating the legs. We go to frame 1 and recreate the first pose from the reference. Basically, we move the back leg slightly backwards, lower the character's hips a bit, and place the front leg in the right position just like in the reference. Alright, now we move a few frames forward. Make sure that however many frames you move forward now, you keep that same spacing for the next poses too, so it forms a proper cycle. The first keyframe is on frame 1 and the next one goes on frame 3, so we move forward by 2 frames. But after that, we'll move forward by 3 frames each time, meaning the next keyframes will be on frame 6, 9, 12, and so on, depending on how much we need. Now I'm going to speed up the video and create the next poses until we reach the final movement. Alright, now it's time for the final frame, which should always repeat whatever happened in the first frame. So we copy the first keyframes and paste them on the last frame. After doing that, you'll see the movement loops back to the starting pose. Now it's time to cycle the animation. So as you can see, after cycling the animation, my character now has a repeating and consistent run cycle. But that's not enough. We still need to make some adjustments to the cycle, and also animate the arms, body, and hair to match the movement and make everything look more natural. Stay tuned for the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe.